What did the prosecution want Jessica to do today? What did they want her to do through this whole trial? They want her to take responsibility. Responsibility for putting her son in this. She's doing that. She's doing that today. She's doing that in front of you. She could have pled out to this indictment. She could have got rid of this case right off the bat. But she didn't. She wanted here today, as I told you in opening statements, as you heard up on the stand, when I asked her, did you murder your son? She said yes. She said she put him in this coffin and placed him in that well. Three of these injuries are healing injuries, and they did happen before March 27. But the major injuries that caused Dylan's death happened on March 27. He died on March 28. You heard her say that. And after that, this is what they did. She's owning up to that. She was forced to come here to try to save somebody who did not do that, that did not kill Dylan. She's here. She was up on that stand. All that was not to save herself. All this week is not to save herself. It's to save him, because she knows the truth and she's told it. How do we know that this baby died on March 28th? Let me explain some of the testimony. Dr. Hudson said there was two visits. There was one on February 7th, where the baby's length was 19.5 inches. There was one a couple of weeks later, where he was 20.3 inches. Dr. Brown stood up on the stand and said during the autopsy he was 20.5 inches, 0.2 inches longer than he was on February 21st. We know that Patricia Kraft has testified that he was alive on the 28th, so he must have died that day. Andrea Bowling testified that she wasn't surprised that Patricia Kraft or Children's Services didn't put all notes into the activity logs. You heard Patricia Kraft testify that she didn't pick him up and look at him. She merely glanced at him. Daniel Jr. himself testified that he hadn't seen Dylan 3 or 4 weeks prior to his removal from the house on April 24th. All that points to that March 28th day, the same day that my client, Jessica Gross, claims that he died. Daniel Gross, prosecution kept saying foolishly unaware. Yes, he was foolishly unaware. She took great care of Daniel Jr. You saw that up on stand. She was a great wife for all these years. Great. Great. She's not using her drug addiction as an excuse, but that she went down that wrong path, which led us to here. The coroner herself said that she couldn't tell what the bruising was, whether it was decomposition or bruising. Dr. Hudson testified to the fact that any skull fractures might not be bruising. There might not be bruising or swelling. I present to you that the state has not provided enough evidence that Daniel is guilty of the murder. I present to you that they have failed to even give you a date of death. I have given you a date of death from the beginning, because that's the true date of death that my client has testified to. I'm not much about theatrics, but my client has told the truth. What more can anybody ask for? What more can you ask from her than the truth? She's up on stand. She tried and tried. It's easier just to sit back in that chair. and before the state starts tossing this around to you to get your attention, remember, she took the blame.
Thank you, Your Honor.